Hello, I'm your artist and host, Denise Justice, and welcome to beautiful Florida. Today's project, we're painting this blue jar. So let's get started. Now I've completed my charcoal sketch and I'm going to put a little bit more shadow where the cast shadow is. As I look at my jar and I see my shadows are on the right hand side, my light is coming from the left, and now we're going to start our painting. And I put the darks in, and I make sure I use enough water so that it's not too heavy. This is only a reference for my painting later on. This is not my final painting. Then I go into the middle tone area here. And I put some of the middle tone in. This way. I see we need some more shadow over here. I'm using just one brush because this is the underpainting and it doesn't have to be that strong. And now I'm going to go into the light area and just put a little bit more light. It's not quite that light. We'll come back into the paint. It's very distinctive. You can see the dark, the middle tone, and the light. And don't forget to add just a little bit here for the shadow and the line. Even though my underpainting is in blue, which is what I use in all of my paintings, blue and blue with a little bit of umber, I'm going to still go in and finish up the rest of this with my color wash because my general color wash is blue. I'm going to add just a tad of red in my blue because there's a little bit of that more in the shadow area right here. Again, keep it thin. You can see your underpainting right underneath, and then after our second coat here is finished, we let again this dry, and then we'll go into our final application of paint. Between each step, when we finish our steps, we want to also clean our brushes out after we finish our first step and our second step, and absolutely when we finish our third. After this step, which is step two, it's time for a break. That we have here. Then I'm going to go into my middle blue here, and in the darker blue I'm going to add just a little bit of black and a little bit of the red again, which will bring it down to a much deeper color. I'm going to go in now and I'm going to start from the shadow end. Now I've added just a little bit more blue on because I also ran out of paint, which is not uncommon for all of us. There's a lot of detail in this ginger jar. However, I'm only doing the basic color. Afterwards, I can always add the detail, or what we call the general color. So I'm going to go in now, and I happen to like a little violet and some of the edges. Now I like to also use a brush that's not too small. I can always add more detail later with a smaller brush if I like. And I add all of the darks that I feel are important first. Acrylic dries very quickly, so you have to move with a fair amount of speed, otherwise you won't be able to blend your colors very well, and that's one of the other reasons that I use a big brush. I'm going to go in the base here a little bit. It doesn't have to look exactly like what we have in the photo. I'm not even going to rinse my brush out in this situation. I'm going to go from one area of this ginger jar right into the next. This is actually a beautiful jar that comes out of Japan. A little bit more red. You'll notice the value is a little bit lighter. I don't use a lot of water in the final application of paint. I happen to like pretty much the dry look, but everybody has to find their way. So don't hesitate to find your particular style. Don't take it all too seriously. Now I'm going to actually walk it again. I'll rinse this out quickly. And I use a paper towel where I constantly am pushing all the water out. And I want to make sure that each of the values are not so far from one another. I can always lighten it up later, but you can definitely see that there's a difference in the values here. We have a light area, middle tone area, and a dark area. Later on, when you do more painting, there's also reflected light, cast shadows. If we miss a little spot here, we can always touch it in a little bit. We can add a little darkness in here if we need to. I think this is a little too light in here. I'll give it just a little bit of red. There's also a little bit of a highlight. And that's in this area right in here. Because it's wet, we can add that right in while it's wet. A little bit down here also. I squint also to see sometimes if there's anything else that I need to. There's really quite a bright light right there. There's a little bit on this side, but since that was from another shadow coming in before when I took the photograph, I'm going to omit it. You have that control, what you want to keep and what you want to take out. So let's put a little bit in here. I hope you've enjoyed painting with us today and that you'll join us again soon. Thank you.